Madame Cohen est post-docteur en architecture concernant entre autres l'accessibilité des personnes avec des handicaps physiques pour le musée. Elle est coordinateur de la recherche, j'essaie de traduire correctement, et elle enseigne la planification de groupe et l'accessibilité à l'Universal Design Pro Access Group. Elle est architecte et urbaniste. Et elle va s'adresser à nous. Je pense qu'on a eu la chance d'ailleurs de vous entendre auparavant dans cet événement-ci. Alors, elle va nous parler de ses recherches actuelles. Madame Regina, je vous cède la parole.
Bonjour à tous. Good morning. I prefer to speak in English. It's better for me. It's more easy. And I'll talk about my research for my postdoc about museums in Brazil. And the cultural destination for all in the Brazilian museums, we introduced a new concept of atmospheres that I will show you. We are a group inside the University of Rio de Janeiro, the Pro Access Group, and the research was supported by financial support research in the state of Rio de Janeiro. And to begin, if you see this picture, everything inside, how we call in English, vitrine, na boîte de verre, je ne sais pas, mais on seulement voit, on ne peut toucher, on ne peut, je parle en français, en anglais. We can touch and we only see what is inside this exposition. And this picture show an interactive moment of persons. It's in the Holocaust Museum of Vienna. The persons are interacting, they talk when the movie passes there. This is real, a museum. This is for me and the research I did. Two child sitting there, interacting with the exposition. And I will introduce you, as I told, the concept of atmosphere. These two figures, pictures, are from the Historical Center of Rio de Janeiro. And if you look at each one of them, you see they are very empty, without no person, nobody. And what happens? What is happening? It's a very good place. And if you see now the same picture on the left side and the other on the right side, this place is a Bohemian place in the city of Rio de Janeiro. On the right side, you have many persons sitting, having shop, drinking and talking, music, and you feel the smell of the shop. You have the hearing of the music, and the atmosphere becomes completely different. Not empty of persons and with many senses and sensations. So atmosphere is a term with many meanings. What gives to a physical space a status of poetic entity, sensorial, and multidirectional. So the concept of atmosphere was introduced by the French, by Université de Grenoble. Atmosphere is the foundation of sensibility, Because it associates the one who perceives with the perceived object. An atmosphere is born for my corporeity with its ability to feel, move, and become an affectionate entity. This is very important. Yeah, all the senses enrolled on the museums, and I need to pass quickly. And here the use of all senses in the access of museum. Touch, see, hear, and smell. And this is a person touching is a museum in São Paulo, Campinas. The first experience in a museum of the interior of the state of São Paulo, a blind person touching a flower with a paint, with a smell, a different smell. A visit to a museum is a pleasure for those interested for art, for knowledge, so a museum can't be forgotten as a product of pleasure, of emotional and intellectual stimulus. This is very important. The senses and the emotional feelings are very important. And here we can see a museum as a product of pleasure, of emotional and intellectual stimulus. A blind person touching a sculpture and feeling emotionally and with the sense of touch. Here is a museum in Piauí. They make experience with the visitor, even not being persons with disability. And this is a new experience in the north of the country. The north of the country, we don't have many good experience, but this is a very new one. Some other examples in Brazil. This was the institution, the pioneer institution in Brazil, in São Paulo, Pinacoteca de São Paulo. This is a painting of an important artist in Brazil, Tarsila do Amaral. You are Brazilian? No, but you know. They were produced in relief, and it was fantastic. The person can touch and feel. They are trying to do many things in the European year in Brazil. And also another picture of a person in Pinacoteca de São Paulo touching another work. And this is the Pinacoteca de São Paulo. They have an educative program, and they are doing more than other institutions in Brazil. And we have also in São Paulo, we have the Museum of Football, the Football Museum. A picture with the football game is presented by five sensorial resources: braille relief, grid contrast, tactile resources, and audio description. The visitor uses hands and ears to understand what is shown there, the meaning of the image. An exposition tries to approximate the difference, show that the blind, deaf, or persons with reduced mobility themselves have a world of perceptions and sensibilities. I will not continue because I know I have time. But this is a picture of the Football Museum. It's a very nice experience. When I went there, there's a person with a bandage in the eyes and touching a football game, a camp of football. They have many interesting things on this museum. View with Another Vision is the name of the exposition. And this was the diagnostic, I don't know, of patrimonial museums in the state of Rio de Janeiro. This was my postdoc. We searched, we have in the state of Rio de Janeiro 15 patrimonial museums, and they are all difficult. The patrimony, don't let to make them accessible, is really very difficult. This one of the most beautiful museums, historical, that I like. is in Petropolis, the is the Imperial Museum of Petropolis. It's very beautiful, and what they allowed us on the research, the field research, for the blind, only to touch the sculptures on the garden, not inside, nothing inside. They are beginning, and we are really beginning. We don't have, in Rio, a great experience. We are trying. And the entrance for persons on wheelchair is that. The picture shows a very bad pavement for wheelchair, and you always need help. This doesn't mean accessibility. Accessibility is without help, any help. And this is also, as I told you, a blind touching a sculpture in the garden of the Imperial Museum of Petropolis. Touching the flowers and feeling the smell of the flowers. He liked very much the experience. And we walked, the persons needed to register their feelings and sensations and what they feel. This is a group where I could go with blind, deaf. There was one deaf person, a person with intellectual disability. We have a diversity of persons with different disabilities. We also interviewed the architect responsible for the institution. And it was really nice. They were impressed with the experience because they didn't have this experience, and it was a real... This is a student in another museum in Rio de Janeiro, the city of Rio de Janeiro, touching, look at her face. He's feeling, look how she's feeling. And she closed the eyes and feeling she's not blind. She's a student, architectural student. And this is the Paraty in another city, the religious art museum. But the route to the museum, the city is completely bad, but it's a very beautiful city, and the story is very big. I don't have much time. So all the data that we collected, we made some directions for the museums, and we published this book. It's only in Portuguese, but it was the Ministry of Culture and the Institute of Museum. And just to finish, Michel Perron, sorry. Also the concept that we created recently, the complete accessibility. What does it mean? The concept of complete accessibility comes from the fact that not only a good physical accessibility is enough to let the space to be understood and really used by all. A full accessibility means to consider more and looks for the adoption of emotional aspects, affectives, and intellectual that are indispensable to create the capacity of a place to welcome their visitors and create the fitness to develop empathy and affect to all users. It was developed by me, this concept, and with Cristiane. Look at the face of the man, feeling, having effect with the museum, a blind person. And the two pictures, this is a new museum being constructed for the Olympic Games 2016. And the other, also for 2016, is already finished. And I finish also here.
Merci.
Sorry.
Merci. Merci infiniment, Regina. J'ai une question ici, s'il vous plaît. Je peux prendre une question? Est-ce qu'on peut, oui, pour le micro? J'en profite pour signaler que Des propos de Mme Cohen, on retiendra que pour que l'expérience muséale soit complète, elle se doit également d'être émotive, sensorielle, donc de dépasser simplement le lieu d'information, mais également devenir un lieu d'émotion. Je traduirai dans mes mots vos mots. S'il vous plaît, monsieur.
Muito obrigado pela apresentação muito interessante. Vai proceder em inglês para os amigos daqui. Obrigado. Eu sou daqui, nasci aqui, mas de origem na Goa, a antiga. But I will switch to English for the benefit of our friends. Sorry about that. I just wanted to welcome you to our city and to thank you. To what extent are the elections in Brazil beneficial to you in your attempts to further the accessibility of museums and cultural sites in Brazil?
It's a very difficult question. We are living a very difficult moment in Brazil, in all the country. The state is also electing directors, but the culture politic, they are investing and giving some money for the museums to get accessible, but not too much. And now we don't know anything that will happen in the future, because we don't know. On this, the next Sunday, we have the election again. We don't know who will be the president, who will be the Ministry of Culture, and this can change everything that are being done, all the things that are being done. But they don't invest too much, and for the patrimony, accessibility is not important. You can't move, change the architecture, and it's very difficult this in Brazil. But the elections, I can't tell you now. We need to wait to know what will happen in the future. I can't answer you now. Next Sunday is very close. And the moment is hard for me, not for me, for all the population. We don't know what will happen with the country. We have two different, but this is a question that I don't want to talk about.